Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and welcome back to this next video. And in this video, I'm going to focus on the palindromes in the DNA sequences. So in the last video, I've told you about the complementarity of the DNA strands, that why the complementarity of the DNA strand is important and what the complementarity of the DNA strand means. So when you talk about the DNA sequences, or when you are going for the sequencing of the DNA, sometime you come up with these palindromes. So the first thing you need to understand is what are the palindromes. So the palindromes, like if you talk about a nucleic acid sequence in a double-stranded DNA or RNA molecule, we are reading in a certain direction, for example, from the 5' end to the 3' end on one strand, is identical to the sequence in the same direction on the complementary strand. We usually call this is the palindromic sequences. For example, if this is one strand of the DNA, and if you are reading it from the 5' to the 3' end, as you can see, this is TGA, TCA. And if you look at the second strand and you read it again from the 5' to the 3' direction, so you can see that this is TGA, TCA. So the same sequence, this is TGA, TCA, this is again TGA, TCA. So reading in a particular direction on both strands of the DNA, if that gives you the identical sequence, these are known as the palindromic sequences. Now, why these palindromic sequences are important? The first important thing is that most DNA cutting enzymes, which we technically call as the restriction enzymes, they have got the palindromic target sequences. So identifying a particular palindrome in the DNA sequence can help you identify the cutting site for a restriction enzyme. Secondly, these palindromic sequences, they serve as the binding sites where regulatory proteins stick, so they can turn on genes, they can turn the genes on and they can turn the gene off. That means that these palindromic sequences, they are very important in the regulation of the gene expression. Thirdly, these palindromic sequences, they have got a very strong influence on the 3D structure of the DNA molecule, and you know that when the 3D structure of a DNA molecule changes, that have a lot of impact on the function of the DNA molecules. So these palindromic sequences, identifying them in the DNA sequence, they can be very important, because with the help of these, you can identify the cutting site for the restriction enzymes, you can identify the regulation of the gene expression, and they can have a strong influence on the structure of the 3D structure of the DNA molecule. So if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button and share it with your friends.